What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's Dan here. Welcome back to Firewatch. We are moving on to day number two now. Let's check it out.
Wake up. Hey, wake up.
I'm here, chill.
I'm awake. What's your problem?
Our problem.
Sorry, our problem.
That storm knocked out the phone line I used to talk to the service, which means we're cut off. I tried radioing out, and that's not working either. I don't really know why that would be the case.
Can I go fix it?
Well, you probably can't, but what you can do is hike out to where the wire runs through your area and report back if it's down. Then I can track down a ranger to get someone on it.
Okay, I can do that. Where is it?
Remember that cave you hiked through yesterday?
Yeah, of course.
So you're gonna want to go back there, go through it, and keep going straight to the north when you come out.
Will do.
Thanks, Hank.
Leave it. Leave that. Come on. We can be on a first name basis. Or a nickname basis. Don't be an uptight asshole. Okay. Sorry, I forgot what we're supposed to... Oh, yeah, we gotta take it. We gotta leave. Alright, north of the canyon. Ah, what a nice day. Window's still smashed out, but I guess... Not really going anywhere, are we? Da-da-da-da-da-da. Da-da-da-da. Da-da-da-da-da-da. Done. Duh. Alright, where are we going right now? Survey communication lines north of the canyon. So I guess we have to go this way. Kind of this way, I guess. And see what's going on, am I right? Yeah, so, I mean, we're kind of off the trail, so let's just kind of get to the trail first. They want north of the canyon. Where's the canyon? Yeah, so let's... It's always so hard to tell. Alright, we're almost on the track here. And it shows where you've been, which is nice. That way you can kind of backtrack if you need to. Bruh. Alright, it's actually quite dark. What's going on here? Are you kidding me? I can't go down there? No, it's all based off of that, so... It's my fault that I took this route. So let's just hope to God that... We can still stick to it. What? I am so lost! Alright, here we go. Ooh. Seriously, man, this job is quite dangerous. I'm not gonna doubt that. Alright, let's see where we are. Oh, we're on the right track, so let's just keep following the canyon. We gotta go north of the canyon. I'm assuming she'll kind of tell us what's up as we go along, I mean. It's so peaceful over here, you know? Can I jump this? I guess I can. Actually, we have to go this way anyway. We have to follow the trail. That's quite the drop. They're not gonna let you cheat. Gotta go everywhere. Surprised that not a whole lot is really happening right now, is it? I guess I should run. Make this a little bit faster. Get that cardio, man. Make sure we're on the right track. Yep. So what I'm going to do then is once I get through this trail. Oh,
it's actually pretty damn cold out here.
Roger that. Warms up fast. The mornings are cold in Boulder, though, right?
Yeah, they are.
What did you get up to down there? I mean, what's life like?
Hold on.
I don't know. Just used to spend a lot of time with our dog, Mayhem.
Mayhem? What kind of name is that?
He was a German Shepherd, big as a truck.
So why not call him Chevy?
Well, we walked out of the shelter and there was some graffiti on a trash can and it said, Dicko Mayhem, and he walked over and peed all over it, and there you go.
That's a really cute story.
It is what it is.
Hey, can you hold on a sec?
Sure. Just gonna keep hiking and hoping it warms up.
Heyo. I don't think so. Why, have you?
What?
Okay, good. No, I don't think he has any idea. I'm absolutely sure. Would you? All right, I'll let you know if anything changes in that regard.
The fuck?
Hey, sorry about that. Anyway, I thought about it, and that story is cute, and, sorry, but you said we? You owned him with someone?
That would be my wife, Julia.
Oh, like your wife? Or like she's taken half my stuff wife?
My wife.
But you're here.
Everything's fine. Just, you know, we're taking some time apart, getting some fresh air.
A little change.
Yeah.
All right. Well, we can just leave it at that.
Thanks.
I hope we're going the right way. I mean, we haven't gone this way at all, so I don't really think there's another way to go. I didn't want to ask about it because I want her to think that, you know, that way I can find out more about it without her worrying, you know, or without her realizing it, so she can tell me some stuff, you know, that, are we still good? Yeah, I'm just gonna keep following this trail. I'm sure she'll chime in. Delilah will chime in. Like I said, man, she sounds like a very, very chill boss. Like, I've never had a boss as chill as Delilah. Okay, that's not true. I've had a couple, but even then. I guess the difference is the work that you're doing, that one would be doing, is considered, this is more fun. I think this will be more fun than the kind of work I did in the past. Beartooth Point and Thoroughfare Fire Lookout. Is that where we're going? Are we going to Beartooth Point? We got quite a ways to go, so I'm just going to keep walking this way. Because it's all about exploration. Right. My bad. Well, there is a lot of exploration here. You could see. There's tons of stuff you can do. I've said this, I think, maybe 6 or 7 times, but I really like the art style. Like, it looks kind of like Team Fortress 2 kind of graphics and art. But that's a good thing, though. It's kind of cartoony, but it's kind of realistic. You know, it's nice. I like it. I'm cool with it anyway. I got no problems. I see a box up here, which is why I'm running this way. Just gonna go see what's inside. Nope. It's fortunate they found so many things. What do we got in here? Six feet under. Put it back. I just want to see what's underneath it. Surprisingly nothing, but there is a note here. Let's go ahead and read the note. Dave, hail. I got your note about needing to talk, and sorry I didn't track you down. Been looking for you all day. Figured you'd be out near the canyon helping those grad students, but I guess not. I don't even know how I could really help, anyway. We're co-workers, you know? Amigos, profesionales. If you need someone to throw a case back with and go time traveling, Ron's your guy, but I'm not great with the life stuff. You get it? Later, Ron. Wow, Ron. No need to be a dick. Alright. Are we still proceeding north? Where are we? Oh, wow. Oh, a turtle! Ah! Adopt! I just adopted the turtle. I didn't talk to her, though. I should have. What's going on here? I found a little turtle here. It's adorable. I'm gonna name him Frank. Oh, wait, where are we? Let me guess. We're at, like, the edge of... Yeah, we gotta go back this way. So I was kind of going the right way, but I wasn't. That's so funny. I got a little turtle, and his name is Frank. Frank the turtle. So yeah, there's certain things you can interact with, certain things you cannot. What's this over here?
Hey, so there are beer cans all over the ground up here leading up the hill.
That's annoying.
Yeah, thing is, there were a bunch down at that campsite yesterday.
Coincidence, the girls. Maybe?
I don't think so. Same brand, everything.
These fucking kids.
How could these girls be so stupid?
Trust me, I never underestimate the stupidity of a drunk teenager.
This is
also
true.
Also, I never underestimate the balls of a drunk young woman, having been one.
Clean it up. I like how you can do this, you know? It's just like, for the environment. We gotta stop these women. I wonder if I treated them differently, if it would have gone differently, or they would have done different things, or... That's what I'm wondering, like, if I was, you know, a bit of a douche. Well, what was that?
I can see the wire you're talking about. It looks like it's in good shape from here.
We'll follow it up to the top of the trail if you can. You can head back as soon as you give me the all clear.
Got it.
More goddamn beer cans. Can I clean this one up? No, it's in pieces. How much goddamn beer did these girls consume? You're telling me that these girls came out into the middle of nowhere by themselves to swill beer and does God knows what else?
Hey, so the wire is definitely down out here. I just found it.
They cut it. The girls cut it.
That's actually good to hear. I can send someone out to fix it. Good find.
Yeah, the thing is...
Damn,
it doesn't
bitches.
It look like the wind. It looks like it was cut deliberately.
I knew it. The moment you said you found their trash. These idiots are gonna pay. Do they realize this is how people die? I mean, what if something happened to one of my lookouts while this was going on? And God forbid there's an actual fire burning out of control.
What do you want to do?
I want you to go find them.
Done deal.
And then what?
I haven't thought that far ahead. That's not true. Everything that comes to mind is illegal.
Let's hear it.
Oh yeah?
Hey, I came out here for a breath of fresh air and some adventure. What do you got?
I think I want you to just find them and scare the hell out of them.
Yeah, I'd make a spooky ghost costume, but they stole my sheets.
I don't know. Wait for them to wander off and wreck their camp. Something that would make a teenage girl run home to mommy and daddy.
I'll find them.
Thanks.
But I am gonna need a raise.
Don't hold your breath. I'd start by hiking back towards your tower and just keep an eye out for anything that would lead you to them.
Copy.
Oh, they're big into Red Eagle.
Great. See if you can find the path they took down from there. Maybe they looped back around towards the lake or something.
Yeah, they probably did.
I doubt they're where they were yesterday, but they obviously can't have gone far.
Just trying to keep an eye out for the beer cans. There's another one, so I'm gonna follow the path. Damn girls, man. What a bunch of stupid bitches. I don't mean girls in general. I mean these girls. These girls are stupid. No, seriously. That's what I mean. That there's no thought process there. They literally are just like, oh, we're going to show this motherfucker. He stole our music. We were doing something illegal. We're going to fuck him up and cause lives to be, you know, at stake. Give me a break, man. None of this childish shit. I'm not actually seeing any more beer cans. Wait a minute. Let me look. Find the teens. Let's see if we go this way. Let's see if we find anything this way. You never know which way they went.
I've got an overgrown trail here.
Yeah, that'll happen.
So I'm screwed when it comes to getting past it?
Mm-hmm. Screwed until you clear it yourself, yeah.
Great. Well, if I come across some tools, I'll add groundskeeping to my ever-increasing list of responsibilities.
Exactly. Alright, so I can't go this way yet. So, that's, I guess, good news. I gotta find maybe some garden shears or, like, an axe or something like that. I'm surprised he doesn't have one. You know, that... I guess he's not a ranger. You know, he's doing a lot of ranger duties, isn't he? But he's just... He's Firewatch. That's different. Makes, like, that conversation kind of makes me wonder, you know what I mean? Two forks. They probably went to the lake, that's the thing. Let's just go to the lake. We'll probably end up going the other way anyway. Just kind of want to keep an eye out. Oh. I don't see any beer cans. I don't have the rope either. Oh, I don't think I have a choice, you guys. I'm gonna have to go back there and get some supplies. Yeah, alright. We need a new rope, so... I guess that's no choice for me. What's this? Ah.
There's an abandoned pack out here.
And it's not one of the teens?
No, it looks like it was lost a long time ago.
Well, you could always pilfer it for supplies.
Truth. Take it. What's in it? Brian Goodwin's. He probably has a rope. Ah! And a camera.
Well, I am flush with ropes now. That pack was full of them, in decent condition, too.
That's lucky.
I mean, there's enough rope here that I could just leave them hooked up, I think. Oh, get this. This pack came with one of those cardboard single-use cameras.
With pictures left?
Yeah, he only used 3 or 4.
Neato.
Thank you, Brian Goodwin.
Wait, who?
The bag had the name Brian Goodwin sewn into the top.
Huh. Wow.
Do you know who that is?
You know him?
Yeah, I just haven't heard that name in a few years.
He was a lookout?
Yeah, kinda, I guess. He was stationed in Two Forks, your lookout, with his dad Ned 3 summers ago. Great kid.
You can bring children out here?
No. You know, I'm not a stickler for rules. They took off halfway through the summer.
Why? Where did they go?
I don't know. I never really hit it off with old Ned. And, one day they were just gone. Sucks. Anyway, so it goes. Have, fun with that camera. Try not to snap anything that would scar a photo dome employee.
I don't know, I got a lot of hiking to do. Might get bored.
Well, I'm bored as rocks, so I'll keep you company while you find those girls, huh?
Can I take a selfie? I don't want to waste the film. I don't want to just take it on nothing. There we go. A little bit more intel. Alright, let's see what it says. Dave, guess who's going out with Debbie next week? No, not that shit heel Steve. It's your man, Ron. I went up to check The new guy at Two Forks and heard him talking to himself. More than usual for LO's lookouts. So I figured I'd stay away. Remember when you saw Chimney Rock having himself in that hammock? Ew. I'm starting to think the Forest Service only picks the deranged and perverted. Except for us, of course. We're the creme de la creme. Let's toast to Deb at the spot. Ron. I feel like I should hold on to these just in case.
Someone found a fossil and put it in a cash box.
Oh, really?
That's kind of cool, man. That's like a raptor claw. I guess we're going to the lake. That's where they said they probably went. They gave you, like, one of those, maybe they went this way kind of a deal. Alright, so it looks like... if I head kind of to the right like this, this will bring me to the right trail, which will head me straight down south to the lake. And I think I've already been to the lake, but I'm not sure. Right? Is this the right way? Yeah, I'm going to stick this way then. See what we can find.
Hey, Delilah?
Hey there, Delilah. We have got a fence.
No, not yet. Why would there be a fence out here?
Because sometimes hikers go ass over tea kettle when on a trail.
So the Forest Service would put up a big chain link fence?
A chain link fence?
Yeah. It looks like it surrounds a huge area.
Huh. That's weird.
Put it back. I got a reply.
Do you think those girls could be behind this fence?
Well, having once been an ornery young woman, the last thing I would do is climb a fence. Especially if I knew I was in trouble.
I don't even know how I would get in.
It's really strange that that's out there, by the way.
Yeah, it's weird.
Interesting. Well, let's take a look at the map. So that ain't happening, I guess. I'm not going to be able to get over that. Not yet, anyway. Maybe I'll be able to come back. I saw something. God, give me that.
Hey, I can see your tower. Suppose that means you can see me.
Yeah, well enough.
Can she? Let's see, do we want to go this way? Just to get... no, let's make our way down. I think it meets up. I haven't found a beer bottle or a beer can in a while. See, I feel like I want to check this out, but I don't think I'm allowed to go in here yet. I mean, you could easily climb it, but I think what they're saying is when she replied that way, that's not where they are. Don't bother going there. But where are we on the map? Let's take a look. I'm kind of off the beaten path at the moment. Not on the trail, but usually you can find some stuff out here when you do that. That's a shitty flashlight. Just saying.
Just so you know, I didn't mean to overstep my bounds earlier when you brought up your wife.
I know you didn't. You were just making conversation. I appreciate it.
So, tell me about her, if you want.
She's a college professor. She's a PhD in biology, evolution, and stuff.
Ooh, evolution. That's a risque subject in these parts. Man, she sounds sexy.
She sure was.
Where does she teach?
Yale.
Yale?
Yep, the Yale.
Shit, Henry.
She flew back and forth. I hated it.
Yeah, I would too.
Yeah, anyway, that's her.
Cool. All right, let's ask about this.
From this burned section of forest, I have no idea where to go. Their trail is pretty cold at this point.
You're out by Mule Point. No one would camp out in the fireweed. Well, I want you to stay out there as a favor to little old me.
My pleasure.
Okay, we know these young women are sloppy. They must have left some sort of trail.
Well, I guess we'll find out. Just keep an eye on stuff. This is kind of neat, though. I like how they do this. Where are we? The region supply drop. That's somewhere I skipped. Now, in theory, I probably should have went there, but... I'm just trying to keep an eye open for stuff at this point. We don't even know how old they are. They could be 18.
I'm having a hell of a time getting this fucking flapjack off his ass and out to repair that wire.
Excuse me, flapjack?
You know, like a loser, a chotch.
I really don't, but I do now.
Well, the next time you're at a bar and some banker steps on your foot so he can order his crappy martini, you've got just the name to use.
Hey, flapjack, why don't you wait your turn before I bounce your face off a dumpster?
It's beautiful.
Huh. I like the banter, man. It's dope. I swear I know her voice, too. The one who voices Delilah. I think she was in a few TV shows. I'll need to hear her again before I could say that. She's got a specific tone about her. Well, now here's the thing. At this point, I don't really want to go down there just yet. I feel like there's something else I'm supposed to see. At least I have the rope set for later. Because I feel like Delilah kind of chimes in when, you know, when you're getting, you know, progressing kind of in the story.
Do you see anything from yours, like, you know, like clues as to where they could be?
Clues. I really like your enthusiasm for mystery.
I'm just doing my job.
I like it. I do. I can't wait for you to give these girls a piece of your, our, mind, minds, collective. But no, no clues. I can't see anything from here.
Son of a biatch. Hey, what's that? I don't just want to be going in circles. There's so much stuff to look at.
You know, if it makes you feel any better, you're a member of a diverse club of lookouts that have come to the thoroughfare after a breakup. There was Vernon, whose wife got put away for running cocaine. Becca, who was widowed after her husband, a jockey, was trampled by his horse. And Sharon, whose boyfriend had his own boyfriend.
Ooh.
Maybe you boned the neighbor. Maybe she boned the neighbor. Maybe you both did. I don't judge. And if you ever want to talk breakups, I'm your gal.
It wasn't anyone's fault. You know, neither of us boned the neighbor.
So you just grew apart?
We just couldn't be together anymore.
How does that make you feel?
Not very good.
Sorry.
Yeah, what are you gonna do?
Have I been here before? That's this cave. I think I've come full circle at this point. Yeah, this isn't new. Well, I don't know where to go at this point, man. Like, it's all very, you know, very much the same. I figured it'd be, you know, I think I need to go back to that one section. Come on, let me climb. You're not gonna let me grab the rope? There we go. I don't know. Any clues? It's annoying that she... I mean, I don't understand how she'd be able to see anything from that tower. Like, this far out? You know what I mean? I mean, she thinks that they went back to that lake. But I don't think I've actually even been to that lake. So I think what I need to do is go where I originally planned and head on over here. Drop down the canyon, head west through the canyon, and head to the lake from there. That's my guess. Okay. Let's just get to walking. Because this is all new stuff.
Wow. I'm on top of a natural bridge out here.
Really? Is it a complete arch?
No. I guess the bridge is out here. Still, I think I could jump this gap to get across the canyon.
Wow, you're a regular Evel Knievel.
Oh, yeah. You should see the jumpsuit I'm wearing.
I love their banter. That's like half the fun. Look at that view, though. Bruh. Had to snap a picture from here. Truly beautiful. Back in the days when, you know, disposable cameras were the thing, you went on trips, you just bought a disposable camera, and you were done. I'm sure a lot of the kids nowadays don't even know what the hell a disposable camera is. And you had to wind it back, you know, it's just old school, bro. It's old school. I've never been this way. So I have a feeling like I'm going to find something. You know, I'm going to run into somebody. Or some piece of evidence that I've been looking for. They say the girls were sloppy, so... The hell is that? Bruh. That's kind of a creepy sound. As long as it doesn't go dark, I'll be okay. Where are we now? Jonesy Lake. We gotta go right. Ah. So wait a minute. Was I here before? I must have been. Yeah, I must have been near the lake. Because wait. No, let me just make sure. Because I've already looked in this one. This was one of the first ones. Oh, granola bar.
Hey, there's a snack in here. I'm probably gonna eat it.
You definitely do not want to do that. Whatever's in there has been in there for years. That's how you get food poisoning.
Okay, fine. I'll put it back. I thought I ate the other one. Isn't that the same one? But I ate it. Oh, you're kidding me.
I see a really thin plume of smoke.
Yeah, I see it too. A thin plume like this is either a new fire or a campfire.
Campfire? You think it's them?
I reckon so.
It looks like it's to the southwest of me.
That's right. If you hike towards Five Mile Creek, that should put you in the neighborhood.
Copy that.
Keep an eye on that smoke plume. Let me know if it's getting any larger.
Will do.
You know what I should have done, bro? I just realized. Remember when I picked up the radio? I should have thrown the radio in the water.
I'm down by Cripple Gulch.
You ready to give it another shot?
Do I seriously have to?
To get down to Five Mile Creek? Yeah, afraid so.
Don't be such a baby,
it's
man.
It's quite a ways downhill from here.
You had a bad rope last time. You gotta... Remember what's his name? Dude gave you some really swagadelic ropes.
Nope.
Here we go. I have a feeling like the main boss battle is going to be these girls. You know what I mean? They're just going to be your arch nemesis for however long. It looks like a tornado, kind of, doesn't it? All right, so let's... See, that's why it's a troll. I mean, it could very well be on the other side. Because, yeah, we haven't been to this area, so I guess that was a telltale sign right there as well. But if we start, like, searching everything around here, you know, we eventually will go to every single spot. It may get a little confusing, depending where they are, you know? Hopefully it won't be too bad. Got kind of hazy, didn't it? One thing I particularly noticed, though, is that you don't ever really see anybody per se. You know what I mean? It's all silhouettes. All right, see what we got. Oh, it's giving you lake paths. There's a missing persons thing here.
How many hikers go missing in the Shoshone?
More than none, unfortunately, with most of them being in this area. The thoroughfare, because it's so remote. Why?
I found an old flyer for a missing hiker. It just got me thinking, that's all. Like how you... All
right, let's just read this real quick. Mitch Michaels, age 31, height 6'2", 165 pounds. He's pretty light. Short brown hair, identifying feature distinctive facial hair, general info. Mitch Michaels was last seen around Jonesy Lake on July 3rd, 1981. He was first reported missing on July 29th, 81 by Forest Service personnel. He is not known to be familiar with the area. Last known location, Mitch was seen around Jonesy Lake on the morning of July 3rd, 1981. Vehicle info, 72 Ford F-250 blue and white, Montana license plate. You have seen contact with them? Okay. It's just for...
Said one day you were talking to the Goodwins, and then the next you weren't.
Ned Goodwin didn't get mauled by a bear or stuck in a ravine. He was just a PTSD'd a-hole who dragged his son out to do a job and realized it was a bad idea.
You really didn't like that guy, did you?
I don't know. I just had a hard time talking to him. I mean, there are lookouts who seriously won't shut up, who call me about every little thing that pops into their head. And then there are those who just want to be left alone. He was the latter.
And I'm the former, aren't I?
Well, I didn't want to say anything.
No, it's fine. I'll just chuck my walkie-talkie into the river.
Oh, come on.
And you'll never hear from me again.
Finally, peace and quiet. Woohoo!
So...
Isn't your radio supposed to be in the river?
I couldn't bring myself to do it.
Well, I guess I'm stuck with you then.
Yeah. So, did you mention something about Ned Goodwin having PTSD? That doesn't sound good.
Yeah, I don't know. He was in the army. He was off. It's actually the saddest story. He was only discharged because his mother, Brian's grandmother, died. She'd been taking care of him, and Ned was the only next of kin.
Damn. And you got to know Brian a little bit?
Yeah. I talked to him way more than I'd talked to Ned, that's for sure.
How was he at, spotting fires?
Better than you. He actually liked to stay in the tower.
Let's just talk about this.
Boy, for as dry as it is this summer, there's an area down here that's lush.
Oh, you must be talking about the Aspen Grove down there.
Yeah, I think that's where I am.
Those trees are actually one root organism. Did you know that?
I didn't.
Yeah, they share their water as a colony that can live for hundreds of years, even through fire. Can you believe you're actually getting paid to learn all of these amazing things? Also, by what it looks like on this map, you'll be coming up on a stream that should lead you towards where we saw that smoke.
Ah, okay, now we're I was worried I went the wrong way there. Here's the stream. So let's take it this way. Look at those god rays. Oh.
It's a really nice waterfall down
here. Something in this tree.
Given those girls love a skinny dipping, I bet they're nearby. There's some cloth out here. It looks like it was torn from something.
Strange.
I'll keep looking around.
So that's a beautiful waterfall, man. Okay, I don't think we can get anywhere this way. Let's go ahead this way. Maybe we can find the ladies. Hello? I think I found it.
I see a campsite, and it looks like they've got a fire.
Is it them?
No, it seems like it. I swear, they must have dragged 4 cases of beer out here.
Track them down, and don't let them see you.
What a job this is. I have entered the teen zone.
Oh, really? And where's that?
What a bitch!
It's the name of a magazine for girls. It's on the ground here at their camp. Well, I found some dangerous hunks.
What? on earth are you...
It's another one of those magazines.
I'm trolling at this point.
These girls have a full case of beer left here. A full case.
Let's take it.
Well, they're impressive little shits, I guess.
That is some dedication.
This bitch. I knew it was them.
Ah, found my sheets.
So they did break into your tower.
Looks like...
Take it. Can we take it back?
Pants are back.
I'm sorry, pants are back?
Well, according to the experts at Teen Zone magazine, it's unclear where they've been. The pants, I mean.
Where'd the pants go?
I don't get why the hunks have to be so dangerous.
Well, you're clearly not a young woman.
Girls should want nice hunks.
Ugh, boring.
Can we not, is that all we can do? Actually, I think it is stomped out. That's annoying. Okay, so they're nearby. Can we troll their bed, their, like, sleeping bag?
Their tent looks like it's been through the shredder.
Damn, that's...
would explain that scrap I found.
Uh-oh.
What could have done that? Like a bear or, I don't know, it sounds crazy, but even a bull elk if it's off its rocker.
Look at
Whatever
this.
Whoever did it did not hold back.
You've got that camera, right? It might be a good idea to get a few snaps, just in case.
Yeah, good thinking.
Let's try and get a close-up, maybe, from this side.
Some of their clothes are all torn up.
That's not good.
No, this is actually pretty bad now. Now that I'm seeing this.
You know, maybe I should take one of their sleeping bags as payback.
At this stage, take whatever you want.
What's the note say?
Looks like someone left a note.
Intriguing. Maybe you should read it.
Okay, yeah.
Let me know what it says.
Let's take a look. Dear Psycho, I hope you're fucking happy. We're leaving and we're going to find the police or whatever and tell them about how you creeped on us at the lake. Sure! That's fun. And then came and destroyed our campsite and all of our stuff. We didn't break anything. Oh, and stealing panties is gross out. I didn't steal it. You're probably a mental fucking axe murderer and are so going to jail. I hope it was worth being a jerk over some fireworks, dick. Makes me wonder if there's someone else. Let's hold on to this note.
Well, they're gone, for sure.
Well, what's it say?
Threatening to call the police because they think I attacked them.
Oh my god, well... Did you?
No!
No, well, hey, I didn't do this, okay? Someone or something went to town here, but it wasn't me.
Because I told you to scare them, not assault them.
Yeah, I took their whiskey back at the lake, but that just felt like, I don't know, the cost of doing business.
That's different, okay? And I don't blame you.
This is, I don't know, weird as hell, but it wasn't me.
It's okay. I believe you. Weird stuff happens in the woods. It could be other campers. They could be having a bad mushroom trip. We really don't know, but they're gone. There's no way to call the cops. They're not coming back, and we can get to work. I'd really like to start enjoying a quiet summer.
Yeah, me too.
I don't think that's gonna happen. All right, ladies and gentlemen, so this concludes day number 2. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to hit that like button. Favorite as well, let me know your thoughts in the comments below. And be sure to check out my social media and more links in the description below. Thank you so much again, guys, and we'll see you in the next one. Who the man with the plan? If you feel trouble wild and wild, don't use violent and hit Q8000. Wait a minute, hold that stylist dial. Dan, goddamn Billy Jack, we still riding tires flat. I hear them sirens, see shots flying, so we driving fire back. If they ain't vibing, lie with that. Got me dressed up in all black. What up? Hood up, and I see them haters try to run with us. They don't need inhalers. Gotta breathe them hard, just like the beta players. Grab your respirators. Night invaders get lightsabered. Mask on for the shooters. Move like trash to bed intruder. Got that Glock and got them woofers. Just press play, I'll keep it moving. Who is not? Kill you damn fools. Keep it fresh like canned food. There ain't nothing we can't do, so tune into that DanQ. Yeah. It was never, ever a game.